Thank you for playing Catchphrase. Dude. We are champs.
Forever. I will have that championship.
Forever. Yeah.
Yeah.
I love when you come on. We always play a game and do something fun. But also, we always have big news and exciting things to talk about. Last time you were on, you were about to announce that you were about to go to Broadway in a new play, and you got a Tony Award nomination, buddy.
Can you believe that? What?
I'm just saying, that's pretty awesome.
It's kind of amazing. I mean, I was the little kid who recorded the Tonys on my VHS and like...
You used to record the Tony Awards?
Yeah, on the VHS. Am I aging myself?
No. Everyone remembers VHS. VHS, yes, right. Of course, videotape. I live by it. But you would record them to watch them over and over again?
Throughout a year. Yeah, like I literally would, it would be, you know, my little VHS that I would watch over and over again, the musical numbers and...
No way.
Yeah.
Is that where you kind of got your first bug and like, I'm going to be on theater one day?
Well, my grandma took me to see Joseph in the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat when I was 7. And that's when I was like, this is what I'm meant to do.
Really?
Joseph in the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat.
Jamie, yeah.
Yeah.
Who was in it? Do you remember? Was it Donny?
David Cassidy. No,
David Cassidy.
I think it was David Cassidy.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow, that would have been fantastic.
Yeah.
And that's where you go, that's it. I want to
do
this.
Yeah, this is what I want. There was a little girl on stage, and I was like, this is what I am supposed to do.
One of the things that is the biggest, obviously, getting to Broadway is a giant honor, and it's so cool. But getting to get your caricature drawn and hung up in Sardis.
Yes.
Is another honor.
It's
altogether.
Huge. It's a huge thing to do, and you don't know necessarily how it's going to turn out. There's an unveiling.
There's an unveiling, and you got it. And by the way, great unveiling. It's fantastic.
I mean, I was so excited when
Did you freak out? I love Sardis.
I love it so much. I mean, it's really part of, like, the Broadway New York legacy. Yeah.
I mean, did you ever go to Sardis? Like, when you visited?
Yeah, I mean, I couldn't afford much at Sardis, you know, because it was... Yes. Fancy. It was bougie.
It is bougie. I can't believe you got bougie.
I can't believe it.
But it is fancy. Yes, you just go in and look at all the famous stars, Broadway stars, and you go, one
My
day.
Favorite is they had Bette Davis and Joan Crawford right next to each other.
Ooh! Like,
there's a standoff till the end of time.
I mean, that really is. Do you know where you are?
I don't.
Yeah. Some people come on the show and they go, I'm at Sardis. They go, I didn't like my placement of where it was. I go,
interesting.
I don't think it matters. I think I would take, Sardis, if you're listening, I have nothing to do with Broadway except that I'm lucky to have great guests on my show that are
touched. You should have a caricature of
I would love to. I would go anywhere you put me. I'm so happy. You could put
in
me
the in bathroom?
Yes.
All right.
Want to be in. I love to be in the bathroom.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. It's an honor. I'd love to go anywhere.
Honor.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
I would go and just search for me. If you find me, you get $2 off your food or something.
There you go.
It's such a cool thing. I also. I follow you on the socials, and I saw this photo of you backstage with Taylor Swift. I mean, this is another thing to... Another thing to check off. You go, that's pretty cool. What, you saw her in Mexico City?
So, yeah, I was in Mexico City, and she was touring there, and I was like, I'm going to go to Taylor's concert. This is my assistant, Allie, and she is obsessed with Taylor Swift, and it was, like, the best day of her life.
Oh.
And I met Taylor. She's actually really sweet.
She's the best.
The best. It's crazy. I met her in 2011 at the Met Ball. And we were both, it was like the first year I was invited to the Met Ball, first year I had movies out. And we were both sitting next to each other. We were like next to Ryan Murphy, who was just starting to become successful with all of his TV shows.
Fun table.
And she was so sweet. I just went through a breakup, and I was talking to her about that. And, you know, we went and danced together. It was such a fun night. And then the next day, I had an email from iTunes that said, like, Taylor Swift, whatever. And I just thought it was a Taylor Swift album. She had made me a breakup playlist that she sent me. Isn't that the sweetest thing?
Are you kidding? That's unbelievable.
I know. And here I thought it was like a Taylor Swift advertisement. And it was like, wait a minute. And she like curated all these breakup songs to send me to help me get through my breakup.
Oh, that's what I'm seeing. That's why she's who she is. I'm so happy for her. Can we talk about your movie?
Yes.
Let's talk about Memory. Speaking of awards, again, you just got nominated for an Independent Spirit Award. So congratulations. No big deal.
There we go.
No big deal.
I mean,
You are so great in this movie, and I love Peter Sarsgaard as well.
Isn't he? He was playing air guitar here recently.
We played. We had fun. But I was telling him, watching you guys play, it's like watching Federer versus Federer. It's like watching two pros just play, and you're watching this, and you're like, oh, it was just so well done. I mean, you're so great at what you do. But how do we explain who you are, who your character is, and what the movie's about?
Well, the great Michel Franco, he's the writer-director, wrote it. And it's about, I play Sylvia. She's a social worker, and she's an AA, and she's had some trauma in her life, and there's a lot of memories that she longs to forget about. And she meets Saul, who has early onset dementia, and there's a lot of memories he wants to hang on to. And it's the bond that these two meet and share that really, I mean, I find it very hopeful and healing and,
yes,
and beautiful. It's a beautiful love story.
It actually is that's a great way to describe it. It's a beautiful movie. And it's and there's some humor in there as well, by the way. Yeah, you see. I want to show a clip. Here's Jessica Chastain and Peter Sarsgaard in Memory. Take a look.
Where'd you go to school?
Woodbury.
So did I.
Really?
Yeah. Now you remember me?
No.
Well, I guess people change after many years.
But we didn't go to school together.
Oh, I remember. You really don't remember me?
No.
Jessica Chastain, everybody. Memory is in select theaters December 22nd and expands January 5th. Memory, check it out. Alanis Morissette joins us after the break. Stick around, everybody.